see a substitute teacher will be hired, or when a teacher, a female teacher, will have a maternity leave, a substitute teacher will be hired in her behalf. But at present, we have teachers who have no valid reason, but not reporting to their school of assignment, and yet utilizing somebody to teach in their behalf. So this practice has a very strong effect on the delivery of quality education. Because aside from allegations that we have been employing teachers who are not qualified, or we have been hiring teachers not based on merit and fitness, there are still substitute teachers who the Department of Education doesn't really know who they are or what are their educational attainment. We really are not, we do not have any knowledge as to the qualification of these persons who are being utilized as substitute by professional teachers. The department is now, insofar as appointments are concerned, this is now under the authority of the Assistant Secretary Nur Saada, and he has been here during our last committee hearing. About 3 weeks ago, we submitted about 200 appointments for the signature of the regional governor, and then we are now preparing, ready for his signature, about 600 appointments. But since we discovered that each division produced his own appointment paper, and they are being submitted to the Office of the Secretary, already being prepared, except only now for the governor to affix his signature, we discovered that each division have a separate form, although they may look the same, but when you take a closer look at each of these appointment papers coming from each division, you will look the variance. So what we did is, we commissioned the printing or the production of an appointment paper that will be uniform to all the divisions. And we provide some security features. There will be now a water mark. There will also be some portion there will have a security feature to make it harder on the part of some persons to copy, or because as we learned from the civil service, it is actually the Civil Service Commission is suggesting to us to submit or to process application in mass, because to the view of the Civil Service Commission is that is one way of avoiding fake or applicants with fake documents or with fake PRC license. But unfortunately, we have the division has to fill in some natural vacancy. So in those cases, there will be two or three appointments that will have to be submitted to the Civil Service Commission. And because we do not have that secured appointment form, it becomes easy on their part to just submit, to process, then to submit it to the Civil Service Commission. Irrelevant to the effort on our part to determine the how many teachers we have in ARMM that do not have the necessary license or permit from the PRC, we discovered that in elementary education we have around 5,000 public school teachers who are not licensed of the PRC, issued by PRC, and there are about 2,000 in the secondary education. By percentage point, no? There are more than 50% of teachers in secondary education are not license holders, and that about 35% in elementary education. But we have this Republic Act 92-93. We have this Republic Act 92-93, which states that a public school teacher who has been serving as such for a period of 5 years can within 2 years from the passage of that law apply for an eligibility without examination. That's become hard on our part, because we have to request from civil service, from the PRC, from the Department of Education, the roster of teachers who apply to benefit from that law. So meaning the around 5,000-7,000 all in all names have not been found in the PRC as licensed. We still have to trace them back to that roster of applicants for eligibility without examination, so as not for us to automatically declare that these persons are teaching without license. If I may now go to EO 19. EO 19 was signed into law last June, but it was made known to the public only last July. And on July 11, a committee hearing was conducted by this August body. Then 2 days thereafter, a case was filed in Marawi City. But prior to that, or even prior to the committee hearing, our office received an urgent request for reconsideration of EOP Executive Order Number 19. Anyway, the status of this case is now with the Marawi Court. The incident to be resolved by that court is the application for writ of preliminary temporary restraining order or preliminary injunction as applied for by the petitioners. The Solicitor General, the Attorney General's Office, and DepEd filed a joint position paper opposing the application on several grounds. I think what have been made out of proportion out of that executive order is not really the merger of the divisions of Plano del Sur 1A and 1B, and the merger of Lanao del Sur 2B to 2A. I honestly believe that it was the misinterpretation of the said executive order. People thought that in that executive order, we were merging school districts, that we were merging national high schools. The provision to that effect was merely a statement of policy to the part of the Department of Education, that ideally there should be only one national high school in every municipality. Unfortunately, at present, for example, in the case of Malabang, aside from the private schools they have there, which now about 7 private schools, they still have 4 national high schools. So several municipalities in Lanao del Sur have already more than one national high schools. And as far as the school district is concerned, we now have there are school districts that is being the position of a district supervisor is being held by a public school teacher and is managing only about